We want to rewrite each subtraction problem as an addition problem and then evaluate. So the main thing to remember is that subtracting a number is the same as adding the opposite of the number. So 5 minus 9 is equivalent to 5 plus negative 9. Thinking of this in terms of money, taking away $9 is the same as adding a loss of $9. So using the number line, we'll model positive 5, so we'll start at 0 and move right 5 units to positive 5. And then to add negative 9, we'll have to move left 9 units. So starting at positive 5, we'll move left 9 units. So our sum is equal to negative 4. Which means the difference is also equal to negative 4. Now negative 3 minus positive 1 is equivalent to negative 3 plus negative 1. So again, using the number line, we'll start at 0 and move left 3 units for negative 3. And then because we're adding a negative 1, we'll move one more unit to the left. So we can see that the sum will be negative 4, which is the same as this difference. Let's take a look at two more examples. Here we have positive 2 minus negative 2. To write this as an addition problem, we have to add the opposite. So 2 minus negative 2 is equivalent to 2 plus positive 2. Now again, using the money analogy, subtracting a loss of $2 is the same as adding $2 or giving you $2. So think of it this way. If you owe $2 and I take away that debt, that's the same as giving you $2 to pay off that debt. And for 2 plus 2, we don't need the number line. That would just be 4. So this difference is also equal to 4. And then for the last example, we have negative 4 minus negative 2. Well, subtracting negative 2 is equivalent to adding positive 2. So we'll go ahead and use a number line, and we'll model negative 4. So we'll start at 0 and move left 4 units to negative 4. And then we're adding positive 2, so now we're going to go right 2 units. And so our sum is equal to negative 2. Therefore, the difference is also equal to negative 2. We'll take a look at some more examples in the next video.